So on Tuesday, we talked about functions that are broken into pieces. Those are your piecewise functions. So I'm challenging you to make a graph, and that's what we're practicing today. And as you graph them, you start to understand them more. So it's still building upon just starting to get used to what they are from Tuesday. Maybe it was Monday. So this is what we're going to graph, this g of x right here. And you guys have already looked at it. I picked this because I know you already looked at it for your assignment. So when I said begin graphing the top equation, I meant this top piece here. So on your graph paper, you're graphing y equals negative x plus 4. Alright, so we're talking about y equals mx plus b. You begin at the b value, so here's my beginning at 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. I begin at 4. And then my movement is the slope. Down 1, right 1. And you should kind of check, did your slope really go negative or did you end up positive? So I'm going to go down to the right, down to the right. So hopefully you're not doing it in pain. Any questions on how to make the line? Alright, so there's an if statement that is defining this line. This line is part of g of x only if x is less than negative 1. So I have to locate, and I'm going to give you steps for this, you know, after we do it once, walking you through it, and then you can get some steps, but I have to locate where x is negative 1, and what I do is, I like to put a little dashed line there. And, get the graph right. So here's where x is negative 1, maybe it isn't 1. Okay, that's where x is negative 1. So this says x is less than negative 1. So I'm going to erase all values greater. So this should only be existing to the left of negative 1, where x is negative 2, and x is negative 3, and x is negative 4. So I'm going to erase everything that doesn't fall into that if statement. Make my graph even bigger. So I need to erase all this part to the right. So you got to have a good eraser. So you're erasing in... All of that part of that line was important for helping me create the graph by hand. Desmond as well do this for you in solo graphing calculator, but we're drawing this by hand. We got to get our intercepts. We got to get our slope. But now we go back and say, okay, well, this only is existing to to the left of negative 1, where x values are less than negative 1. Okay, and I have to take into account that this says that x has to be less than negative 1. It can't equal negative 1. So I'm going to go ahead and add negative 1. I'm going to use an open circle. So I'm going to erase again. And I put a big open circle. It really doesn't have to be that. I'm emphasizing it for you. Alright, and then this is our first piece of our piecewise function. It's that whole slope, it's that y-intercept, but it's only when x is less than negative 1, so I had to erase everything greater. Now we do the middle piece. So after you drop the top, move on to the other pieces. So y equals 3 is a constant. It's the flat line, zero slope. There's no x, and that's because the slope is zero. So y equals 3 looks like this. Come up to where y is 3, and it's one of those flat line ones. It was actually, I think that's the exact one that was on your handout when we did the constant function. Questions about a flat line at y equals 3? Alright, so now it's time to erase anything that doesn't fall into the if statement. So the if statement for the middle is x should only exist between negative 1 and 2. So I already have a dashed line at negative 1. I'll go ahead and put another dashed line. And that's the other part of the graph that just helps me see. So I go where x is 2, and that's and so for this middle bit, it should only exist in between negative 1 and 2. So I'm actually going to erase outside of the dashed line. So I'm going to do looks like a closed dot at negative 1 and open circle. And there's a lot of details going on here. Don't get alone. You'll do, you know, 3 or 4 of these and get a chance to practice. This is just your first time. So that's our middle bit. We have both a closed dot and an open circle. And that's because these symbols are different. It could equal negative 1 here in the middle, whereas over here it has to be less than 2. On any vertical line, you should never have 2 closed dots, because that would violate the definition of a function, that for each x value there's only 1 y value. So there should only ever be 1 closed dot on any vertical line. Alright,
our last piece. So this is like graphing 3 lines in 1. Our last piece is 2x minus 5, and I'm going to give you
thank you. Figure out where my green line hits to. It's right there. I'm going to keep that and everything to the right. And then I go through and if you want to look good, you really don't need the dash lines. I also erase the dash lines. So. And that's your graph broken into pieces. This would be considered a continuous piecewise function because when you read from left to right, as soon as you hit an open circle, there's a closed dot that picks it up. And then you move forward. There's an open circle, but right there on that same value, there's a closed dot that picks it up. So even though it's broken into pieces, it's considered continuous because there's no actual space in between x values. There's like, there's something for it. All right. And then I think the answer shows a highlighted.
Can I see it? Yeah. Right. Monday's assignment was paging. Okay.
Okay. All right, so you'll start with that, and then you'll finish this one.
Thank you.
Ooh, okay, great, let's check that out. Okay, all right. Check that out. Switch the right word in there. Both of us, you got your mind, because I showed you last year. So you ran here Monday. And then that's your that's your Okay. Absence is one when you are. Like I didn't let's get up with your assignment grade. So you have to stay on top of it because you have to sign up.
Who's your question on these? I feel like I shouldn't give you one, but
for then you guys generate some steps. You went through one. Anybody think they can come up with a good first step? And it's okay if you say it's not a step, isn't it? So what do you think the first step should be in your graphing if you have this function?
Turn these steps off together.
What do you do first?
What's that?
Look at it. See what you're doing. So I'm going to say your equations separately. So a lot of them are y equals mx plus b, but some of them might be y equals a constant. Some of them might be y equals a quadratic. You're going to see that. That's going to be more difficult for you. It could be and then you're going to graph the first equation. And then my advice is to draw a dashed line. As the if statement. And as you get comfortable, maybe you don't need the dashed line anymore. Maybe you can, you know, see it without the dashed line at the if statement. But I find that that makes my graph graphing easier. These are very specific things, and maybe you feel like you don't need to write them. That's your call. So for x is less than or equal to, I said erase everything to the right of the dashed line. So you erase things that are higher. And I really prefer that you comprehend it more than you memorize the steps. But the steps can actually get you going when you're stuck. And then if your if statement says x is supposed to be existing at the higher numbers, x is higher than the line, x is greater than or equal to, you erase to the left. And sometimes you erase everything in the middle. I'm going to erase everything on the outside. If x is in between two symbols, you're going to erase both the left and the right. And just repeat that for all the pieces. Draw the whole line, erase either left or right. Remember either an open circle or a closed dot. So when you feel ready, you're going to start the first problem. Thank you.
So the middle one is in the middle. So keep that. And the bottom one is here. Everything.
You can do it on there.
Yeah, you can do it on there. I think graphing on that little area can be frustrating. So if you want to do it on the back of the graph paper I gave you, you go right ahead. You got it. Well, the only thing is that on my direction graph, they weren't to graph. So I'm glad you get a graph and stuff like that. If you look at example one, I'm gonna just take a look around and see who's still interested in writing these words down and who's ready to figure out. Got
okay, so that actually sounds like it. But this is I'm going to try to put it on here without getting nervous about it. You can see my huge lines. Alright, so I'll start here with y equals 1. So step 1, I said to actually write the equation. You know, take it out of the fancy bracket. We're graphing y equals 1. That is a straight, flat line. There is no slope because there is no x. That is in a constant family. That's what y equals 1 looks like. So after you plot it, you get to work erasing. So for this one, my dashed line that is a helper, it's not a part of my graph, it's a helper, is at -3.
Okay, and if x is less than, and that means
I erase everything to the right. So did I write that correctly in the stuff? With one person. Yeah, okay, yeah. So I got that. I erase everything to the right of the dash line. Okay. So there he is. My eraser works so good. That's our left piece. So if you finish, make sure you check it out. Did you grab it right? Okay. So the top one done. Does anybody have a question? I do a big open circle. Okay. Middle one. The middle one I already got as well. It's y equals x minus 1. And when I graph that, I begin at negative 1. Slightly different color. And I go right over 1 is up 1 over 1. And you're just kind of writing light. Now you're going to have to erase. And at some point, you just get good at this. You know where to draw, and you don't have to erase anymore. So you're stopping your pencil in the right spot naturally. Okay, so for the middle one, I see two places that I'm going to draw a dash line. The first dash line is already there. So I'm going to do another dash line. At positive 3. And so if the x exists in the middle, you're erasing everything to the left and right. And so often, since we read right to left, what will happen is a lot of students will have equations stacked over here and they've erased too many things this way. So just as you work, you should have a left piece, a middle piece, and a right piece. They should not overlap vertically. It should flow left to right. And it just takes a little bit of practice. All right, and I have to close that on these dash lines. Negative 5 over 3x plus 4, more of a traditional type of slope. I'll go up to 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. And I'm off my graph, and that happens a lot. But that's okay, let's do a little graph paper. Happens a lot. And now I'm going to go down 5, right 3. So if you did purchase graph paper, this is definitely a sign to use it. I'm gonna connect my line. It's got a negative slope beginning at 4. And x is less than, I'm sorry, this means x is greater. So you erase all of the values that are lower. Too much erasing. And then I'm going to go back and I'm going to clean this up a little bit. I'm going to erase the dashed lines because those are just little helper lines. And that's your graph. Oh, I have an error in my graph right now. You see it?
It's a field. The range is supposed to be open.
Yeah.
this one. Yeah, so I did a quick check and I see a mistake. I have two closed dots overlapping. That's an error.
So I have to go back and fix that. Erase and find. Erase and find.
There's always an f of x, there's always an equal sign, and your fancy bracket is a parenthesis, a point, and a parenthesis.
That's your framework. Parenthesis, a point, and a parenthesis.
Okay,
so you want to begin with your framework. Start on the left side. So this is the piece I'm looking at first. I start on the negative side.
I'm going to count slow.
And I'm going to identify the B value. So I count slope on this line. Up one, right one. So n is up 1, right 1, 1 over 1. And the b value is this 2 on the
y axis. So I would write that y equals x plus 2. Invisible 1, 1 here. But when I put it in the framework, I drop the y equals and I just see x plus 2.
Drop the y equals for the framework. And then we gotta turn on the if statement.
So there's two pieces, so I know I'm gonna have an if statement here and an if statement here.
So wherever the graph changes, right, you can put a dash line in, identify where it changes. This is where x is 0. This is existing to the left.
So usually you're going to start with your less than sign, and then the bottom one will be your greater than sign. Typically, you're going to put the less than. If you start on the left, you put your less than here, and you put your greater than here. Typically. That's just a deal. If there's no slope, there's no x value.
Ooh, wow.
I'm going to do that to you right away. So there is a closed dot there. And without the function given to us, we don't know which one we should make equal to. But both can be equal to. It's not two closed dots. It's only one. So pick one that you make equal to.